We are at the south end of Canadian Pacific's Nahant Yard, a former Iowa, Chicago, and Eastern property situated roughly midway between La Crescent, Minnesota, and Kansas City, Missouri. CP acquired the IC&E on October 30th, 2008, and integrated its network into its existing operations. Known today as the Davenport Sub between Davenport and Samoa, the line is one of three represented in the area commonly referred to as the Quad Cities. It's early afternoon in mid-June, where we find northbound train 261 preparing to enter Nahant Yard. 261 originates in Kenoke Yard in Kansas City and runs north to Pig's Eye Yard in St. Paul, with a stop in Nahant to pick up and set out cars. The train is running in a 1x1 configuration with a single CSX unit at the head and a CPGE cut in mid-train. Composed of the cities of Davenport and Bettendorf, Iowa, along with Rock Island and Moline, Illinois, the Quad City area hosts trains from Canadian Pacific, BNSF, and Iowa Interstate. Canadian Pacific is the dominant railroad in the area, with roughly 5 to 7 trains in a day operating over the Davenport Sub. In March 2021, Canadian Pacific and Kansas City Southern submitted an application to the Surface Transportation Board with the intent of merging both railroads into the new Canadian Pacific Kansas City Railway. The STB subsequently placed KCS into a voting trust, and Canadian Pacific formally acquired the railroad on December 14, 2021. If the merger is approved, Canadian Pacific Kansas City will become the first truly North American railroad linking Canada, the United States, and Mexico to each other. Norfolk Southern and BNSF units lead train 253 into Nahant Yard in the late afternoon. The crew will detach the power from the train and run it into the yard tracks for servicing. the north end of the yard, we see 260 pulling down the main track while a remote control switch job shifts a cut of cars on the siding. Iowa Interstate runs a transfer train to the CP. The train is seen here utilizing the connecting track from its Iowa City sub to the CP main. Thank you. 260 passes one of the main riverside parks located between Davenport and Bettendorf. A KCS ES-44AC trails a trio of Canadian Pacific units. North of the CP Main, Iowa Interstate's Iowa City Sub runs down the center of 5th Street in pseudo-street running style. The daily BICB train, Blue Island, Illinois, to Council Bluffs, Iowa, heads west through town with a matched pair of ES-44 ACs leading.
Thank you.
Iowa Interstate crosses the Mississippi River on the Government Bridge, a combined road and rail bridge built in 1865, with the Iowa Interstate operating on the upper level and vehicular traffic running on the lower level. The BICB train heads west across the bridge, while the BNSF Rock Turn Local returns west on the CP. The Iowa Interstate transfer from CP crosses the Government Bridge in the early afternoon. We're on the sidewalk along the lower level of the Government Bridge as a trio of GEs lead empty grain train 375 North, BNSF's Crescent Rail Bridge, U.S. 67's Centennial Bridge, and the Mississippi River's Lock and Dam No. 15 are in the background. On the Illinois side of the river, along the Great River Trail, as a pair of light Iowa Interstate GP38-2s come off the government bridge, heading back toward Moline. The BICB heads west along Railroad Street in Moline with the Williams White & Company building in the background. Thank you. power for BNSF's Barstow local returns east to Barstow after working the small yard in Rock Island. On the Iowa side, the Rock Turn local ducks under the government bridge on its way to work the Arconic plant in Bettendorf. I-60 heads by the waterworks switch. The spur to Eldridge branches off the Davenport sub here.
Thank you.
The Riverfront Trail runs closely alongside the Davenport sub, just below Bettendorf, the location of a radio-controlled switch siding. Northbound 577 approaches the siding where it will meet southbound local K60. The Celebration Bell paddle wheel boat trundles down the Mississippi River with an excursion out of Moline. The family-owned business operates regularly scheduled excursions along the Mississippi River from April to October. a northbound local passes the Isle Casino Hotel in Bettendorf. Thanks for joining us for this look at railroading around the Quad Cities.